Hello, my lovely people. You're welcome back once again to my channel. If you're seeing my face for the first time, my name is Tina Isawa. I'm a YouTuber based in Owerri, Nigeria. So if you haven't joined this family, please click on that red subscribe button down below that says subscribe and join this family. Turn on the notification bell beside it so that whenever I upload any content, you will not miss it, okay? And at the same time, give this video a thumbs up because definitely you're going to enjoy it or support me, okay? So you're welcome. Today is a very special day and I want to say, I am grateful all out. Anything we put our hands must work. The Lord go open door for us. You too go be a boss. Amen. 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 So guys, I'm officially 1 year on YouTube. Ba, 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 ba. As a content creator, I started it off on the 19th of April 2020. I know a lot of people started YouTube the year 2020, and I'm happy, I'm super excited to be among the people that started it off, okay? It's not easy being a content creator. You are always thinking about what's the next content, what do I do to get myself better, how do I keep my audience, and a lot of things attached to it. People are even seeing me now as a celebrity, as a big YouTuber, me wasting a bath for Belle. Guys, I'm so excited and I want to use this opportunity to say a little prayer. I've actually prayed for my subscribers, for my family members here who have been supportive in different ways. People I call to ask questions, not just sharing my video, not just watching my video, not just giving it a thumbs up. A lot of ways that you guys have made this journey so memorable that I'm not considering any time, even in the nearest future or in the farthest future, of quitting this business, of quitting this fun loving thing, you know. So I'm very, very grateful and I want to use this opportunity to say thank you to you all and for God who has made it possible for us to cross our path. I say may all glory be unto him. So my fam, the first thing I will do, this is actually a Q&A session. I put it up on my community tab, my Insta story, and yeah, WhatsApp. A lot of people ask me questions, so I want to like answer them fast so that this video will not be too long. Well, even if it's too long, guy, support your baby girl, support Mama Triple J, that I have actually clocked 1 year. I didn't quit. No, he who fights and run lives to fight again. So if I took a break and come back, I'm coming back in full force, okay? So I appreciate you guys. And I got a lot of questions, very juicy questions, that even when I'm reading them, I'm feeling like, wow, this is like content. This is like a content on its own. And I have them here. I have the questions here. This is the one on my community tab. I have the ones on my WhatsApp, the one on my Insta story. So I'm going to be jumping right into it. I may not be able to call names because I wouldn't want this video to be long, but you know your questions. So the first question will be, what would be your reaction if your hubby said you should stop YouTubing? And the simple answer I will give you is this. Before I started YouTube, I had this discussion with my husband that I want to start YouTube and the reasons why I want to start it, and he approved of it and has been supportive. But if for any reason today he wakes up and say, babe, you have to stop, as a human being, I know perseverance is something that everybody in different life you live, in different ways of living, you always persevere. I will try to convince him, try to beg, persevere, persistent, and if at the end of the day he insists, this is Africa, I will still say to your tent, oh Israel, you know what that means. So the next question is, do you see yourself ever giving up on this platform if the views aren't encouraging? I don't see myself. See, there is something I want to highlight here. When I started off YouTube, I wouldn't say I was doing extremely well, but as I'm the one creating the content, I always feel it's good. yeah, I would say I was doing well, a lot of views were there and stuff like that. But there is something that, I don't think I've heard this from anybody, but there is something that is giving me courage to keep moving. Last year, there was total lockdown almost all the countries of the world. And people were in their houses watching YouTube. They have the data, they have the time at home. Even those who work from home. It's a difference between when you're working from home and when you're at the office watching YouTube videos. So people are more like outside now. They are busy now. So the fact that the views are not coming as I would want it or as it was, I am not giving up on YouTube. Someday, I'll get there, okay? I'm not quitting. No. So the next question is consistent. I want to use this opportunity to tell you that you are doing a great job. Thank you. I admire your strength, consistency, and boldness. Thumbs up. What is your motivation and who is your role model? And what are the benefits when working for the government in Nigeria? Okay, this is like three questions. The first one is, what is your motivation? I'm looking like, look, let me tell you guys, someone on Facebook yesterday said, our future Linda Ikeja. I was like, wow. So my motivation is that let me impact on people positively. Either my lifestyle that I put out here will encourage someone, or any content I create will make someone better in the society. So that's my motivation. Not just that I want people to know me, or that I want to make the money, though I'm not sugar day here, go chop them. I'm not saying no to the money, but my motivation is what I stand to put in people's life. Yes, that's my motivation. Then the next one is, and who is your role model? On YouTube, I have role models. Like, but one thing I have to highlight is that the reason why I see this person A as my role model will be the different, it will equally be different from the reason why I see B as my role model. So I will say I have lots of role models, and you want me to call their names? Hey! So that I will not call one other person name, you say, So my role model is Jesus Christ on YouTube, and he's the only one that can help me to blow, okay? And the next question there is, what are the benefits when working for government in Nigeria? Yeah, the benefits of working in Nigeria is this, for government precisely, is that, like now, if your child is sick, I'm using that as an example, you can easily call your direct boss, I cannot come to work today, my daughter or my son is sick, and nobody will query it. You don't need to start making protocols, or you are sick yourself, or anything, family matters, they're always considerate when it comes to that. So I think that's the areas we benefit, not the money, yeah, but time, just time. You can have time, you can go to the office and decide to, like, let me use my break and go to market, and from there you jackpa, no be talkable. So things are, these are the things you stand to benefit. Aside that, there is nothing that, even the retirement that people used to see those days, working for government, when you retire, you still have something coming into your purse. It's not reliable anyway. So what I just told you now is the only benefit I can think of. Then the next question is, congratulations on your 1 year growth to God be the glory. And then, thank you. What has been your biggest challenge on YouTube? That's my question. Honestly, I took a long pause to think what is actually my biggest challenge on YouTube. As I speak to you guys now, I can't think of anything. When you talk about the views, like I said, I'm being patient, which I would easily say my challenge is that the views are not coming, but I'm not worried about it, to be very honest with you. I wouldn't say sometimes I don't feel, you know, I feel, but it's not a challenge to me. And for the things I'm using to film, the data, and it's not a challenge to me. I live within my limits, so I can't see anything as a challenge for me on YouTube now. No. So the next question will be, does your husband watch all your videos? No, he doesn't. I have to be very honest with you guys, he doesn't. He sees it that most of the times when I'm editing video at night, he's always by my side most of the times. Yeah. So what's the essence of watching it, he will feel like, he will always tell me, I've already heard what you said there now. But some cases he watches, and yeah, most of the times when he travels, he watches my videos. Yeah. Then the next question is, congratulations, what was your husband's reaction when you first told him you wanted to start YouTube and upload content? He said, I hope you're not going to bring me and my children inside it. That was what he said. I said, no, I just want to be creating content as a public health worker, create my health topic content, and maybe other topic, like I already explained this. So he was like, okay, but now he's featuring, my children are featuring too. So the next question will be, hi Madam Tina, I love watching your content and I must confess that you have really inspired me to keep up with my YouTube channel. Wow, that's amazing. My question is, please, when can I do a collaboration with you? Smally like me. Are they here? Me atanda. The next question is, Mommy Triple J, yeah, amazing content you've got here. Keep them coming, please. Thank you, Derry. My question goes this way, when are we hanging out to eat fish? Me. Hello, Ma. Just bring it on. Any day, anytime, my pals, I'm ready to fly. But I have to consider, I have to make sure that my children are safe before I can leave. So the next question is, congratulations there. Have you ever feel like quitting YouTube before? And how do you feel when you suffer to create a content and you will end up getting little views on them? Have I ever thought about quitting YouTube? No, I've never. I'm very honest with you guys. I've never. Then the fact that your views are not coming, I'm just being patient to create, more or like to have a foundation towards what I can easily do. Not just coming off my comfort zone. Sometimes I could equally do that, but what I could easily do without compromising my family. That's the answer to the question. So let me ask this juicy one. Oh my God. So this person said, can you speak your husband's language and can your husband speak Igbo? How do you handle finance in your marriage? Wow. That's one of the questions I got. I was like, this is a content on its own. I cannot speak my husband's language. As in, the only thing I can hear, I talk about my language is how are you and one or two things. But funny enough, I am not exposing my husband. My husband doesn't even know his language. Did you hear what I said? He doesn't know. He can understand when the mom speaks. He understands. But to speak, like communicate for 10 minutes, 20 minutes, mba. So how can he now learn my own Igbo? No, he doesn't know how to speak Igbo. Yes, he doesn't know how to speak Igbo. And he doesn't have the interest. That's just it. I'm not forcing him. I'm not learning his own. He's not learning my own. So since we have a means of communication, that is English. No wahala. So the next question there is, how do you handle your finance in your home or in your marriage? In a sentence, my husband takes financial responsibility in my home. From this lipstick I'm wearing till the last thing is his responsibility. But like I always say, if you as a woman, you're making money, take out time. You don't need to discuss it with your husband. We need this, let me just say, we want to change our seat in the dining room, or you want to just like one day surprise him, babe, I'm going to buy this thing, I know we need this thing. Take out your money and buy it. And when you see that you do those things, you'll be feeling like you're not a wasteful wife. You are a helpmate, you are a supportive wife, yes, that's the word. So, in my marriage, financial responsibilities, they are my husband's duties, and he doesn't see it that it's not his job. He sees it that he's doing what he's supposed to do. That's the fun part of it, yeah. So the next question will be, congratulations, Tina, my favorite YouTuber. Thank you. My question is, can you give breakdown or a rough estimate of IVF in Nigeria? Also, I love your market and cooking vlogs. Are you the last born of your parents? No, I'm not the last born. I have two younger brothers. Also, I love your consistency. You never disappoint. Love you and your beautiful family. Thank you. I'm so honored. The that of the estimate of IVF in Nigeria is one of my most requested video, and I promise you, as you're watching this video, the next one or second video coming up will be that one. Okay, thank you. Then the next one is, you are doing well, more grace. Someone has already asked the question I wanted to ask. Okay, the next one, congratulations. My question is, what is your greatest challenges on YouTube since you started, and have you ever thought of quitting? I think I've answered this question. I've never thought of quitting, and for challenge, for now, even if I have to lay my hand on anything, I will say the fact that the views are not coming, but it can never make me not to create content. The fact that the previous one didn't do well, didn't give me views, will never stop me from creating content. I'll keep going. Let me tell you, I think, who was that said that before she got her 300 subscribers, it took her almost a year. So if people who will feel that they are our role models, they have made it on YouTube, took years to get there, and I'm just 1 year, why should I give up? No, I'm not quitting. No. My next question will be, in one of your videos, you mentioned you are an IVF mom. Did you have the problems conceiving naturally? I wouldn't say it's a problem, because if it was a problem, maybe we would have identified it. But I said 1 year, no baby, no pregnancy. Second year, no pregnancy. Third year, no pregnancy. Fourth year, no pregnancy. And everything seemed okay. So we had to decide to go for IVF. So I wouldn't call it a problem, because there was no identification of a particular issue, okay? From both sides. So the next question is, hey baby girl, yeah? Congratulations. What motivated you to start up your YouTube channel? Thank you for this question. No, so I would say someone motivated me, actually. She is a Nigerian, but not in Nigeria. I'm not going to mention her name. And because of her content, I was like, let me start this YouTube. Let me start this whole journey and document everything. Eh? Okay, so one day I'm going to let the cat out of the bag and tell you guys when it's properly ripe. I'm going to let you guys know. For now, I want to keep it anonymous, but I think she would want me to do so. Yeah. Then the next question is, beautiful woman, first of all, you are stunning, and congratulations on your 1 year anniversary. You have done so well. My question is, what keeps you motivated about YouTube? Yes, the fact that there is always light at the end of my tunnel. That's what keeps me motivated. Yes, I forgot to say that earlier. You have done so well, okay? As a 9-to-5 person and a mom, and at the same time a YouTuber, what keeps you going? So personally I feel that I'm doing well. I've not gotten there, unless if the people who have been praising me, throwing accolades here, are just deceiving me. But if they're being honest and me assessing myself, comparing myself with some other persons, I feel that I'm doing well, so I should keep going doing well. One day I would get there, okay? So the next question is, congratulations Tinawa mama, just love your consistency. Biriko, blowing you love from Germany. Thank you, God bless you. So the next question will be, congratulations Tina, what was the reaction of your parents when you told them you are marrying a man from Edo State? In fact, let me tell you, they thought that something was wrong with me. They thought that they have judged me, that this guy gave me something that is not free. Take her to church, take her to prophets, let them check. The fact that they were equally, someone was actually coming for my hand in marriage and the guy lives abroad, you know, but no evil husband. So for me to say no and want to agree to somebody not just from my tribe, the fact that we are living in Nigeria, they felt that something was wrong. Give her time, to she will come off it and let us pray, that kind of thing. But at the end of the day, I told them it was my mind, that was what I wanted, so they had to give in. So the next question, which I think will be okay, second to the last, big congratulations girl, how best do you manage stress, especially now you have no help? I scream, everybody leave me, what is it, do you people want to give me? That's it. Then the last question is, how much have I made from YouTube since I started YouTube? I've not made so much of a money. I know I've not gotten to $1,000. But basically, I shouldn't say I am not on YouTube for money. But I started YouTube, I've said it in the video I started much earlier, why I am on YouTube. I think I highlighted it there. I never knew that YouTube pays money. Yes, one of the reasons I started YouTube, because I had the gadgets, I had Canon 700D camera, I had ring light, the ring light I'm using now, I had it before even the thought of YouTube, and basically a lot of things. The phone I'm using to film now, I had it before even the thought of YouTube. So I think I never, it was not because of money, but I felt that I have what it takes to continue creating content until I blow. When I blow, I'll come and tell you people how much I cash out every month. For now, some months I don't make up to $100, but we'll keep going, okay? So if you want to support me, if you want me to be making $100 and above every month, share my video, watch it to the end, let the audience retention be good, okay? Share in your comment, share in the WhatsApp groups where you belong. If you are a content creator, share in your community tab. If you have never shared my video before, share this one out, okay? And celebrate me since you cannot give me some dollars, or less if you want to give me some dollars, okay? So you share it so that people can watch, so that I can make $100, you know that? So thank you guys, this is about it. I think I so much love the questions you guys asked me, and if you want me to be doing Q&A here once in a while, please shoot it. Anything you want to ask me, feel free to give me content idea. I always create time. As I'm talking to you guys now, this is 20 minutes to 4 p.m. My kids are back. They're in the living room watching television. I have made dinner as I speak to you now. I've prepared the things and done all the things that I need to do, and hence I'm making this video. And probably I will edit this video today and upload it today because it's long overdue. I turned 1 year on YouTube on Monday, which is 2 days ago, so I'm supposed to have made this video and upload it. Sorry, forgive me if this video is too long. I appreciate you guys. God bless you. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe and join this amazing family. Turn on the notification bell, it's very important so that YouTube will know say you really want to watch me, okay? Then give this video a thumbs up and share, okay? God bless you until we see some other time.